Good morning. Welcome to the celebration of Mass on Radio Veritas, the fifth Sunday of Lent, Year B. Mass this morning will be celebrated by Father Mathieu van Vlierden.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, today is the fifth Sunday, the last Sunday of Lent. And in the readings today we hear that the Lord is there to make everything new. And he forgets all our trespasses. He wants us to start all over again. And I think that is a good theme for the preparation of this last Sunday, for this last week of Lent, that we can get ready to receive him when he rises again and wants to take us with him to new life. And in order to be able to do that, we have to admit that we are sinners and ask him for forgiveness and believe in his goodness and compassion. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to eternal life.
Amen.
And let us pray. By your help, we beseech you, Lord our God, may we walk eagerly in that same charity with which, out of love for the world, your Son handed himself over to death. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. First reading, a reading from the book of Jeremiah. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah, not like the covenant which I made with their fathers when I took them by hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt. My covenant which they broke, and I showed myself their master, says the Lord. But this is the covenant which I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it upon their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. And no longer shall each man teach his neighbor and each his brother, saying, Know the Lord, for they shall all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity, and I will remember their sin no more. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial psalm, create a pure heart for me, O God.
Create a pure heart for me, O God.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to your merciful love, according to your great compassion. Blot out my transgressions. Wash me completely from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin.
Create a pure heart for me, O God.
Create a pure heart for me, O God. Renew a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence. Take not your Holy Spirit from me.
Create a pure heart for me, O God.
Restore in me the joy of your salvation. Sustain in me a willing spirit. I will teach transgressors your ways, that sinners may return to you.
Create a pure heart for me, O God.
The second reading, a reading from the letter to the Hebrews. In the days of his flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to him who was able to save him from death, and he was heard from his godly fear. Although he was a son, he learned obedience through what he suffered, and being made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation to all who obey him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory and praise to you, O Christ.
Glory and praise to you, O Christ.
If anyone serves me, he must follow me, says the Lord. And where I am, there shall my servants be also.
Glory and praise to you, O Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, among those who went up to worship at the feast were some Greeks. Some of these came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and they said to him, Sir, we wish to see Jesus. Philip went and told Andrew. Andrew went with Philip, and they told Jesus. And Jesus answered them, The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Truly, truly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. He who loves his life loses it, and he who hates his life in this world will keep it for eternal life. If anyone serves me, he must follow me, and where I am, there shall my servant be also. If anyone serves me, the Father will honor him. Now is my soul troubled, and what shall I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, for this purpose I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name. Then a voice came from heaven. I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again. The crowd standing by heard it and said that it had thundered. Others say, an angel has spoken to him. And Jesus answered, The voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now shall the ruler of this world be cast out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself. He said this to show by what death he was to die. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends, in the first reading we have heard that the Lord is going to make a new covenant with the house of Israel. And we can ask ourselves, what kind of new covenant? How was it different from the old covenant? And we know that the old covenant, when the Lord took the Israelites out of Egypt, he gave them the Ten Commandments. That was what they should do in order to obey the Lord. And we know the Ten Commandments were given to them. But the new covenant, as the Lord said, I will put my law within them, not anymore written on tablets, but in their hearts. And I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Now, what does it mean that he puts his covenant in our hearts? And I would say, if we think a little bit about it, I would say it is our conscience. God has given us a conscience, each and every one of us, to know what is good and what is bad. We don't need to follow our conscience, but that is, according to me, what the Lord meant in the first reading, that he has put his law in our hearts. Everybody knows what is good and bad, but not everybody follows his conscience. And at the end he says, I will forgive their iniquity and I will remember their sins no more. And I think that should be a very comforting thought for us, that God does not remember our sins. The problem is that we ourselves sometimes have difficulty to forgive ourselves. The gospel is a complete different story. I don't know how to say this, but the Greek were considered to be heathens. They were not Jews. They were not accepted by the Jews. So you can imagine that Philip was amazed when they came to him. And some people explain, why did he come to Philip? And some scholars have said they came to Philip because Philip is a Greek name. So they might have thought if we go to somebody with a Greek name, he might accept us. And Philip did not know what to do because they had a complete, very unit, what you call rather enclosed circle around Jesus. So he was asking himself, should I bring them into it or not? So he asked Andrew. And Andrew was a guy who knew for sure that Jesus would not refuse anybody who wants to come to him. And therefore he went straight away with Philip to Jesus. And then Jesus, we don't know if they ever met Jesus, because it doesn't say it in the gospel. It just says that Jesus was saying what is going to happen to him. And if we want to follow him, we have to go to suffering as he does. And the funny thing is, when I was reading that, I thought about the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus said more or less the same thing as he says here. He says, what should I say? Father, save me from this hour. And he says, no, I came for this hour. And we remember in Gethsemane, he says, Father, if it is possible, let this chalice pass me. But not my will, but your will be done. And that is about the same thing he says here. And I think, dear friends, if we keep for the last week of the Lent this in mind, that not my will, but your will be done, I think we have a good preparation for Easter. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let us now profess our faith. I believe in one God, the
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
And let us now offer our petitions to God, our Heavenly Father. Let us pray especially for all those who are in a position of power, especially in our church, that they may never think that God is not willing to forgive, never mind what kind of offenses they have done. As we heard in the first reading, I will forgive their offenses and I don't remember their sins anymore. Let us pray. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us also pray for ourselves that we may come to realize that God has given his law in our hearts and that we should follow our conscience, because there God has told us what is good and what is bad. Let us ask him that we may be faithful to his word. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And let us also pray for all those people who somehow have lost courage and have lost faith because of the difficulties they met in life, that they should realize that Jesus has gone the way before them and that his suffering ended up in glory, and that their suffering also, if they faithfully care it, they also will see the end of it. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us now pause for a moment and offer our own personal prayers. And all these prayers, Lord, Heavenly Father, we offer to you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquities. Cleanse me from all my sins. And pray now, brothers and sisters, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Amen. Hear us, Almighty God, and having instilled in your servants the teaching of the Christian faith, graciously purify them by the working of this sacrament. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your Majesty, since by the wondrous powers of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exultation we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, O Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us,
Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Buti Tlachali, our Archbishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, religious, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Oh,
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen.
And let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that we may always be counted among the members of Christ, in whose body and blood we have communion, he who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Bless, O Lord, your people who long for the gift of your mercy, and grant that what, at your prompting, they desire, they may receive by your generous gift. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
And have a nice Sunday.
Thank you, Father, same to you.